Hello everyone, and welcome to our first patrol on the new server. Like to welcome you all to this fire patrol. So tonight we got a pretty full crew on fire. Not many, but we got pretty basic worth of firefighters, full crew basically. As you can see, we got a big ass pink Jeep in front of us, which I'm going to back up so that they can there we go, pull forward, and we have a new fuel script, so I'm going to show this off. See if it actually wants to let me fuel today, because I've got pretty high amount of fuel on this vehicle, but we'll see. There we go. Alright, one thing is fuel script's a little bit buggy. We run out of fuel pretty quickly, and like especially the medics for some reason, so we're just trying to deal with that. Especially Medic 5, it seems to run through gas in like 2 seconds for everybody. Senior firefighter Becca can actually run it pretty well, but it just depends on how you drive it, because it's actually counted on how you drive it. So I'd like to welcome you to this patrol, and we'll see what we can get ourselves into. Let's go back to the station. I will show you all the new station after I finish patrol. The patrol's finished later on, I'll do a recording of it. Just so I don't get any lag or anything, as you can see, they've lighted up 90 on it. So yeah, we'll get into patrol. Responding to a call of a 1050 for a crash, an MBA. You can hear the new sirens I've got in at the moment. I'm just wanting to test them to see if you guys like them or not. If not, I personally like them, they're pretty good. I like them. They're
come on, damn it.
I think they're sounding pretty good. The only thing that doesn't change, I believe, is the which I haven't tested correctly yet, is the engine. But we don't have the engine added today at the moment, so we just have the brush or our mini pumper or our squad or whatever you want to call it. I usually call it squad. Or
damn, rescue's hauling ass.
Yeah, I know, right? The. But yeah, I just thought I would,
unaware at this time. We can go ahead
let's
and
go to this
keep an eye out, cross lane the traffic. If necessary, we can go up to the gas station and make a U-turn.
250 to fire.
Cut.
Do you guys have a current call in the tunnel? You know, that one. Have you been alerted of that yet?
Is it for a motor vehicle?
It's going to be for a motor vehicle crash with entrapment. There's no way to get here coming southbound. We want you guys to come up into the tunnel, opposite lanes, so come up north in the southbound lanes of the tunnel. There's no way to get access from the other side.
Just turn around.
Caution.
Or if you're the brush truck, you can just literally drop.
Be able to get down here, you know,
yeah, that was a nice little
track.
Shoulder to make a turn.
Well,
we can't get through the tunnel.
The brush, if you want, we'll do our best to make it through the tunnel.
Myself in 148.
Try and skip beside it, maybe. Run her up onto the side. Run her up onto the side. We'll just do that. Careful about the mirror. Continue. See if we can. Done it. God, I wish traffic got out of the way. Ooh.
This is as close as we're gonna get. Bar 61, we're on location. We're about 15, 20 feet out from the scene. We can't.
Hey, buddy, you having pain anywhere?
Everywhere.
Alright. Sit tight with us. We're gonna try to get you out as soon as possible.
Just get changed in the
gear. Bar 61 on scene. We're gonna have command at this time. Single vehicle, motor vehicle accident.
Come on, dummy. Move up forward.
We're gonna be investigating further.
Let's go.
Southbound lanes of the tunnel are going to be completely blocked this time. Medics, you might want to stage just outside the tunnel. We'll have to transport out.
Oh my god, I swear to fucking...
on scene.
Blood all over his head.
There we go. Let's do this
one here.
Dude, move.
Okay.
Yep, 48, we got beer cans everywhere.
Yeah, I've noticed it. A strong odor of alcohol, too.
Alright, all right, you said this door's jammed.
Yeah, every single one is. I've tried to open them.
Alright, let's go outside, pop the window.
Yeah. Do you have a... Do you have something that you've got on? Have you got something on you? Yeah.
Of course. Hang on. Let me throw a pair of glasses then. Bust up my.
All right. I'll move back a little
bit.
Bam,
if you want to check on the guy in there, there's one too good.
There's another one. Okay.
Can you move back a little bit, just so that you know he's gonna smash the window and it might get in your eyes.
Be advised, I'm gonna try to move the medic around and come down the opposite way of direction so we can get to the patient.
Good. Alright, I've got this door open. Guy, if you want to go into the brush and grab my jacket, we're going to throw it over this guy and we'll start attempting to extricate. Where's rescue?
Yeah.
Alright, we're right here. It's, the truck's way back there, though. It's not getting farther than that.
Okay.
I don't think they're going to be able to pull the line.
You want to grab the electric jaws and cutters and the hydro ones out of the bumper?
Hello, my name's State Trooper. Can you move?
You go to the rear. We've got a set of battery operated ones.
Move.
Alright, there you go.
I can
help me.
Hey, I got the guy to move a little bit. You might be able to get further.
Help me.
Alright, I'm going to climb into the truck through the window. Fuck this.
Hey man, can you drive forward a little bit? No? Of course you can't.
Help me.
Sorry man, I'm gonna help you out.
Do you wanna, have you got a C-collar?
Not yet, I'm just gonna get the jacket on, that way we can start extricating. If you want to bring me a
Hey, Campbell, can you get C-collar out of your bag and just pass it to...
Yeah, here you go.
Just pass it to me and I'll give it to Becca. Thank you. There you go. Let's put that on.
Alright, we're gonna try to go through the passenger or the driver's side.
I ran the
plate. Go through the driver's side. I've got him covered. If you want to punch out the window on his side as well, he's covered now.
Copy. Window's already punched out. Double check.
Fuck, if you want to get me a IV kit.
An IV kit? Yep. Campbell.
Get the medic around.
Campbell. Right, yeah.
I need an IV kit, a vial of dope, or a vial of morphine, as well as just a saline bag.
Alright, can you give me
just
that?
Pull it
form.
Out my medic bag.
Right,
the local there has absolutely no blood pressure, so I'm just gonna call him.
Yeah, 1144.
All right, Campbell, if you want to pull him out and try compressions for a little bit, wouldn't have to do more than 2 rounds because it's not a witness arrest, but I would try it.
Alright.
Alright, my clothes
are cut. There we go.
Alright, so let's get the vehicle cribbed and we'll get ready for extrication. We need to stabilize it first. Fox, if you want to go over to the rescue, grab probably 15 4x4 is a set of chocks, and then just a set of V-triangle, or a set of wedges. We can get to securing it, and then we'll get it open.
Yeah, right, cool.
There's no signs of life at all. Blood pressure is 0.
Okay.
To 0. I think there's much we can do.
Yeah.
just saves typing it all up. Plus, I hate English and I'm not the best at English, so I'm just not going to be bothering with typing all that up. Alright, I'm going to start cribbing the vehicle.
What do you suspect, DOA?
Do we know how long the accident took place? How long ago?
I don't know.
How long have we been on with me?
Let's, do me a favor, Brandon. Grab his seatbelt, hold his chest back to the seat, so that way he stays tight to the seat.
Oops.
And then grab his seatbelt and yank it to get it to lock, and then let it come tight. That'll hold him up against the seat for us until we're ready to cut him out. One strong tug of it should be enough to get it to lock.
Let's get up here.
Keep on working to him until we have the next patient extricated.
Alright.
And my head's gonna go through the fucking...
Sorry, I gotta go 10-7 quickly.
Okay.
Hey man, can you hear me? Sir? Alright, he's out. Or not.
Help me.
Alrighty, sir. How much pain are you feeling? For a bit, huh?
Yeah.
I can't feel anything.
You can't feel what?
I finished cribbing. We can start it. We can start getting him out.
Alright. Let's make sure we have his face covered.
Yeah, he's got his jacket over the top of him.
Got my jacket over him.
Got me. Starting to cut.
So how are you going in there? Are you okay?
I can't feel anything.
That's alright, man. We'll deal with you in a second. We're just trying to get you out at the moment. Yeah, we're trying to do that in the moment. We're just trying to get you out.
I'm gonna cut. I'm gonna cut off his right sleeve, and I'm gonna start back.
Alright.
Put this vehicle in park and shut off the engine. I'm gonna call him at 2041.
All right. I'll bring the brush around because I've just finished cribbing, and I'll see if I can get the brush around to the other side.
Probably good there. I mean, we don't really need much out of it. It's just manpower at this point.
Yeah, it's alright. I just kinda wanted to move the damn thing. It's not like it's sitting there.
Alright, almost got it here.
Surprised this traffic isn't having a fit. That's actually doing pretty good. Sorry, I'm not talking to you guys much, just
He's flatline for continued.
His coffee's cold. It's only been sitting there for a couple of minutes. Although I have had it for about half. Yeah, fair enough.
Driver's side door's off.
Alright. I think just call it DOA at time of death. At least for my watch is 9:17.
Yeah, same here.
Oh, sorry. Muscle spasm.
All good. Yep.
Alright, you guys gonna write the report up for it?
You wanna take that door all the way off, or you just wanna get it open?
The, doorway report.
I'll also let the coroner know. Yeah.
Thought I got it all the way off, but I guess this'll work.
Yeah, just, do up the doorway report when we get back to the station, and, Rebecca can do the report. Of the call, the incident report. Or he'll just get me to do it, one of the two.
Alright, what we're gonna do is, Brandon, if you look at his seat controls, are his seat controls electronic, or are they the manual ones? I know it's a silly question, but...
I love when it's manual, because you can just don't have to worry about the bloody having tricks.
This is a newer truck, so my guess it is.
Alright. Awesome.
Nah,
rear door.
It look, from here it looks... Yeah, no, it looks like it's a manual. Yeah. All right. Seat, so.
Alright, if you want to open up the rear door right behind the driver.
Alright, yeah, let me get this open.
Actually, that might be jammed, come to think of it.
I mean, just, there you go.
Okay. I didn't try it.
Yeah, he was probably just jammed a little bit. He probably is having trouble getting it open.
So what we're gonna do is, Brandon, you stay in that corner.
You'll hear me sniffing
Drino
a little bit, maybe.
Most of feet
tonight, I've got
a little
bit
lever,
of cold.
And then, Brandon,
it's
what you're gonna
my
do
mute
is
one.
Very, very slowly...
In summer, which is pretty funny.
You're gonna
whatever.
Start to pull the seat back
well, not really
down,
summer, but warm weather.
And it's gonna lay him down flat, make it a lot easier to get a backboard in there and underneath him. Storino, before you do anything, go ahead and cut his seatbelt. Because his seatbelt's locked and it's not gonna be able to be undone. So if you wanna cut it, it'll come off.
There we go.
Alright. Now, Storino, go ahead and pull the lever, and Brandon, make sure you have a firm hold on that seat, and then start to pull it down slowly.
Okay. Go.
Alright, I've got pictures of the vehicle.
Alright, Campbell, if you want to throw that backboard over to... your best bet would probably be to come... to where Brandon is and then slide it in from the back.
Yeah.
Alright. I gotta cut it down as much as I can.
Alrighty, sir, man. Stay with me. Alright, let's get that backboard underneath him.
Yeah.
We got two tow trucks coming.
Alright, tech four. You have a heck of a time trying to get back here, though.
Yeah.
There we go.
Alright, let's spider strap him. Spider strap him and then block his head.
Okay, all good.
Block his head if we haven't already.
Okay. You got that Campbell back there?
Yeah.
That sounds good. And then, you guys already cut the B-post, correct?
I need to reset up on my uniform stuff.
No, we haven't yet, but we can take it out.
I'm probably just
going to
clear it out,
the
and then,
we can take him out through the front.
I'm probably just going to clear
Since
it out and make a new
back,
set.
We have enough angle room where we could come out and over the driver's door. The B-post is going to take a little bit more time. If we want to cut it, but, I mean, is it worth the time for a little bit easier?
Yeah,
nice
let's do that.
Alright. Alright, so Campbell, you're going to stay back there. Brandon, if you want to go up to the front with Storino. Alright, on my count, what we're going to do is we're going to slide the backboard. We're going to take his head and push it towards the back passenger door. And then that'll turn the end of the backboard with his feet towards the driver door. And then we'll come out at an angle up over the joint of the driver's door.
Yeah.
Alright, one, two, three... Alright. Oh. Head over that side.
Oh, let's get some extra hands on here.
Like clockwork, he's out.
Oh,
let me grab the striker if you guys want to stay there.
Yep, got it.
I'm gonna get off the road before we explode into flames because that's about to happen. Because everybody's, because they're out of the vehicle now, it's gonna be traffic moving and shit.
They're getting a bit impatient. Okay, let's move them over here. I'll hop in the driver's seat.
Let's watch them over here, they're not really needing me at the moment. Plus, traffic's about to get a little bit more hectic. As the medic.
Alright, you guys got tow on the way for these vehicles?
Yeah, tow just arrived for this one.
Alright, yeah, sorry. Trucks are back there.
There's a lot of traffic back over that way.
Medic 5 is en route to pillbox with the patient.
I'm gonna turn the engine off just so that I don't have this engine running out of gas anytime soon.
Medic 5, be advised, that gentleman did have a cut on his on a laceration to the leg.
Alright, watch out, guys.
I did
stand behind my car.
Cover it up with a 4x4 and started to hold pressure before you guys left if you want to have somebody take over pressure on that, as well as start dopamine 10 micrograms. Hang 10 micrograms of dopamine through his IV to start bringing his pressure up.
And this is when the vehicles start.
Be advised, that gentleman has a 16 gauge IV in his left AC, wide open, with 5 milligrams of morphine as well as just a normal saline solution.
10-4.
This should hold up traffic to clear itself. It better not fucking. There's a lot of fucking trucks here, I swear. Like, there is so many people.
I think they're trying to yield over into this right lane because of this gentleman right here.
I'm not sure where my... Oh, okay. 148. From zero.
God.
Alright,
I don't really have a way to move this guy.
Yeah.
Let's just wait it out. He'll be back in a second.
I'm talking about this guy right here. I don't really have a way to move him out of the road to clear
traffic.
I do. Give me a
sec. Oh,
gotcha.
No, I don't.
Idea, but...
Yeah, no, it's not gonna work. Trust.
Yeah, we're just gonna have to get corner out here. And then be on.
I have one solution, but it's gonna require a little bit of space, and I think everybody's gonna have to leave.
Alright, you guys
if
take
that makes
off.
Any sense.
We're gonna open up the lid.
You wanna deal with it? I can deal with him, but I need everybody else to leave.
It's fine. We'll go away.
Okay. Yeah.
But anyway, let's get out of here.
Alright, Fox, if you want to get the cribbing picked up from where the truck was.
Yep.
And then restock that into rescue before rescue heads out. I've never seen him.
I think that's how you spell it.
Out with
cribbing
underneath him,
but anyway.
Power to him.
Hey, I'm just gonna restock just put all this on it.
Alright, I'm opening it up.
So forgive me for my bad spelling. I just yeah.
Rescue 28 back 10-8 and route to quarters.
Hey Fox, I'm gonna be 10-6 for just a few moments, so I'm gonna hop in and let you head back.
Yeah, copy. Just go around that because there's a. Object just sitting there, that's why the vehicle crashed, I'd say. Squad 61's gonna be back in route to quarters. Alright, hello everyone, and Well, I'm doing this station finally. It's before I upload this, basically. So this is the new station. It's got none of the apparatus in it at the moment, apologies for that. But that's the original part of the station, that's where the medic and any command vehicles go, so the most active, well, the active ambulance at the time, which is usually Medic 59 at this point, because Medic 5 is out of service, as far as I know still. This is where engine goes, and a rescue goes in that one. Brush also goes in this one, sometimes we'll put it in the other area, just so it's easier to walk through. We try and sit the brush right against this wall here just so that we don't have, we can actually still walk through to the main area. So if we follow our way into this area, we can see that this is a sort of a outdoor barbecue area, I guess. Not really that much. It's not too much out here. It's helmets and stuff over there. If we follow this way in here, we're going to go into the main area of the building, which is the lounge room slash kitchen and dining room, I guess, main area of the building. If we go in here, this is the changing room. So that's the changing room in there. We go up here, and it's just like phone and all that sort of jazz, not really stuff that you don't really see that often. Go in here, see that this is the briefing room of the station. We haven't used it yet. The office. Now one of these is vice versa. I don't know which is which. They both share an office, I guess. I don't know which office is which and whether they have a specified office. If we go down here, see there's an ironing board there and a fire extinguisher. There's a window out to there. Now on each side there is different living areas. So this is just sort of resting area for everybody. Everybody has jokingly assigned themselves certain rooms, so, and I had a, they were all joking about that, so I basically said that I'll assign myself to the medic and I'll just sleep in the back of the, not medic, but the brush. But yeah, just showing off the rooms. It's not much else to the station really. It's a bit of a short one. This one has a computer in it, so, you know, it's kind of a good one. But yeah, just thought I'd show off the station. It's not too much else to show off. So you'll probably see more of it in the more episodes to come. But yeah, this is just basic part of the fire station. But anyway, I'll walk back outside and yeah, we'll just basically yeah, nothing else has changed. The interior of the other building, well, the other part of the building, is still the same. But yeah, it's sometimes that's there and sometimes it's not. It's not supposed to be there as far as I know, but it's whatever. But yeah, just thought I'd show off that part of the building. Thanks for watching the video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and I apologize for the lag. It's also in this video in any stages. But yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. So you know when the next video comes out. Alright. This is Fox Gaming. You showed Fox Gaming 10-7, 10-42. Have a good night, everyone.